الحمد لله رب العالمين، له النعمة وله الفضل وله الثناء الحسن. صلوات الله البر الرحيم والملائكة المقربين على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين الميامين. اللهم علمنا ما جهلنا وذكرنا ما نسينا وزدنا علما ونعوذ بك من حال أهل النار. وبعد، فقد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: الأنبياء إخوة لعلات، دينهم واحد وأمهاتهم شتى، وأنا أولى الناس بعيسى بن مريم، ليس بيني وبينه نبي. That is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the prophets, they are brothers, but not from the same mother. He resembled the prophets to the brothers who are not from the same mother, in the sense that their religion is one, but the Sharia, their rules, there is difference in the rules between the prophets. Some difference in the rules between the prophets. All of the prophets, they have the same religion. Their religion is Islam. Islam is the religion of all of the prophets. What is Islam? Islam is worshipping one and only one God, who doesn't resemble any of the creation. Allah, the creator of the whole universe, does not resemble it. Allah does not resemble the light. He's not light. Allah does not resemble the angels. He's not angel. Allah does not resemble the humans, does not resemble the wind. Allah does not resemble any of the creation. No matter what you imagine, Allah is not like what you imagine. You might imagine something big surrounding the world, but Allah is not like that. Allah is the creator of everything, creator of the world, creator of water, creator of light, creator of sun, creator of heavens, creator of paradise. So he does not resemble any of his creation. All of the prophets, they believed in that. And they called for their people to be on this path, on this creed. All of the prophets. No prophet told his followers, worship me, or I'm the son of Allah. No prophet said that Allah sits over the throne. You know, some people, they say that Allah has created the seven skies, and on the seventh day he rested. He sat over the throne. This is against Islam. Allah, he has the perfect power. He does not become tired. He does not need rest. He does not need any of what we need. He is not in need of anything. We are in need of Allah, but Allah does not need us. When we breathe, who creates our breath? Allah. When we feel whether starving or thirsty, who creates this? Allah. When we walk, who creates our walking? When we speak, who creates our speech? When we think, who creates our thinking? We are in need of Allah in all of our states, in all of our phases. We need Allah. So Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. The only God is Allah. There is no God but Allah. This is the meaning of the testification statement. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. When we, for instance, go to the grave of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for barakah, it does not mean we are worshipping Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we, let's say, oh Allah, by the karama of
Prophet Muhammad, by the honor of Prophet Muhammad, save us from so and so, save us from sickness. This is not that we are worshipping Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The only one who deserves to be worshipped is Allah. And all of the prophets were on that, worshipping one and only one God who does not resemble any of the creation, who is not attributed by any attribute of the creation. We sit. Allah does not sit. We are body. Allah is not a body. There are dense body and light body. The dense body like us, like the stone, like the tree. It's a dense body, it's measurable by hand. And there is the light body, soft body, which is not measurable by hand, like the air, the soul, the light. Allah is not light. So what shall we do with the ayah, Allah nuru samawati wal ard? Some people interpreted this ayah that Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. This is wrong. We don't say Allah is light. Allah is the guidance. At our country, maybe the mother will tell her son, may Allah, Allah yunawwir qalbak in Arabic. Somebody might interpret it, may Allah light your heart. No. May Allah guide your heart. Allah nuru samawati wal ard. This was interpreted by Abdullah ibn Abbas, the cousin of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Allah nuru samawati wal ard. It means that Allah is the guidance of the heavens and the earth. What does it mean? Because when the heavens are residence for the angels, and all the angels are guided. They are Muslims. They are awliya. All the angels, every four fingers, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has said that there is an angel leaning, bowing, or reciting. So it is full of angels. Who made the angels Muslims? The angels are Muslims themselves, because they have saying, they have mind, they believe in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they pray. They pray. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has said, "Man wafaqa ta'minuhu ta'min al-malaika, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi." That was the one. It means that the one who prays at the beginning of the prayer, when the angels pray at the beginning of the prayer, jama'ah, the angels pray jama'ah also, and when he says ameen with the imam, as the angels say ameen with the imam, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ, that is, his sins that he has committed are forgiven for him. Because he prayed at the beginning. Yani, there is more reward in that. There is more reward in that. So the angels, they pray. They are Muslims. They are awliya. Who made them like that? Allah is the creator of guidance. Is the creator of huda, hidayah. Also on earth, not every person on earth is guided, is a mu'min. No. The believers on earth, who made them believers? Allah. This is what cousin of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was called the Turjuman al-Quran, that is the interpreter of the Quran, he has interpreted this ayah. Allah nuru samawati wal ard. It's not allowed to translate it to say he's the light of the heavens and the earth. Because light is a creation. And Allah is not attributed by any attribute of the creation. So all of the prophets, they had the same religion, the same belief in Allah. What differed between the prophets? They have one religion, but different sharia's. What differed between them? For instance, at the time of Adam, alayhi salam, Eve, his wife, she delivered 40 times. Every time it went, a male and a female. But there were no relatives at that time except the brothers and sisters and the father and mother. So how shall people generate? How shall they increase? So it was allowed, according to Sharia of Adam, for the male to get married to his sister, but not from the same pregnancy, from different pregnancy, different delivery. So it was allowed until they increased. During Adam's life, he didn't die unless he saw, until he saw 40,000 of his descendants. That is, his direct sons and the generation after it, until 40,000. He, Adam himself, he taught his children how to speak. It's not true that the original human being didn't know how to speak. He was just imitating the sounds that he hear. Sound of the monkeys, sound of the donkeys, sound of the wind, sound of the storm. No. The first human being is Adam. And Adam is a prophet. Revelation comes to him. By revelation, Allah taught Adam the names of the things. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا